Hello, hello, amazing entrepreneur. It's Tash Corbin here, and welcome to a super duper epic special episode of the Heart Centered Business Podcast. This is episode number 271, which means you can find all the relevant links and show notes for today's episode, and you're going to want to go and grab them over at tashcorbin.com/271. In today's episode, I'm going to share with you my five biggest lessons from having a $1 million program. That's right. The takeoff program has now achieved over $1 million in sales, which completely blows my mind. And so I wanted to do this episode to share with you some of the insights that I have gained from having a program such as Takeoff. And I also, as I said, have a very special opportunity for you over at the show notes of today's episode. So make sure you jot down tashcorbin.com/271 and let's dive into this episode. I'm Tash Corbin, and this is the Heart Centered Business Podcast. So, you heard that correctly. The Takeoff program has had over 570 students in its lifetime. It's almost at 600 students, actually. So, we are definitely nudging close to that 600 student mark. And in that time, the Takeoff program has brought in over $1 million in revenue for my business. I started the Takeoff program in 2014. And I am so glad that 2014 Tash built the Takeoff program. That being said, it has not been smooth sailing by any stretch of the imagination, and there have been some really big lessons for me in creating and launching and relaunching and evergreen funneling and relaunching and relaunching the Takeoff program. So I wanted to share with you my five biggest lessons from having the Takeoff program, launching the Takeoff program, running the Takeoff program, and all the things in between. Let's dive into lesson number one, and that is I should have relaunched the Takeoff program the minute that I finished the first round. And I've talked about this quite consistently throughout my last 5 or 6 years of being in business and here on the podcast as well. I talk about that very consistently because I can see it was my number one mistake with the Takeoff program. When I first created it in 2014, I launched the program, and then it was supposed to be more a self-study program with some live calls included. But very quickly, I realized that people didn't need a course, a self-study course, when they were in this stage of business. What they needed was mentoring. So I very quickly converted it into a group mentoring program, and we had a live round of that first round of the Takeoff program. And once that was starting to come to an end, there were a lot of people in the program who were saying things like, oh, what are we doing with you next? Where to from here next? We had a lot of successes in that first round of the Takeoff program. And so I started thinking about, okay, well, I need to create something else now for the people who graduate from the program. And so I got very distracted for a period of about 6 to 9 months creating and launching Pilot School, which was my program for Takeoff graduates. But I only had 13 graduates of the Takeoff program, and only maybe 8 of those 13 people felt like they were ready for the next step at that point in time. And then 5 of them purchased the passive income program called Pilot School. So then by the time I went back to relaunching the Takeoff program, which is towards the end of 2014, a bunch of people sent me messages saying, oh, I thought you didn't work with startups anymore. How does this work? And it was really, really confusing to my audience. So what I wish I had done was launch the Takeoff program, run the Takeoff program, and relaunch the Takeoff program. If people wanted to keep working with me after the Takeoff program, I could have sold them VIP one-to-one packages. I could have worked with them in that VIP one-to-one way and created way more income for my business, way better results for my business, and not distracted my audience from the fact that I was creating and launching the Takeoff program, helping people in startup. Pilot School had a completely different niche, and I basically unniched my business as soon as I had completed the Takeoff program, which was a big mistake. So my lesson number one is launch the same program over and over again. That creates that compound interest effect. It creates momentum. And that is actually lesson number two as well. Rather than getting caught up in what people would do after the takeoff program, I needed to accept my role was to pick people up at point C and drop them off at point F, not take them from point A all the way through to point Z with multiple programs that went one after the other. Instead, I needed to really narrow down on that one part of the journey. Pick people up at point C, drop them off at point F, and they can continue working with you in a VIP capacity if they want to keep working with you. But it's also very, very legitimate for people to go, okay, I've got what I need out of this. It's time to move on to working with another person. And we are told over and over and over again as entrepreneurs that you want to hold on to each and every client for as long as you can and get as much money out of them as you can and get a recommitment from them if you can over and over again. But that actually shouldn't often be through group program after group program after group program. And actually in doing that and wanting to hold on to people for the entire length of their journey, I slowed down my business growth and stopped my ability to impact more and more and more people quickly in my business. So acknowledge that we don't need to hold on to people forever. You can pick people up at point C on their journey and drop them off at point F, and that is totally fine. Our job is not to see them through all the way to the end of the journey. And then by focusing on just that C to F journey, C to F journey, C to F journey, I would have created so much more impact. My business would have grown so much faster. I would have made so much more money. I would have helped so many more people get their businesses off the ground, because it eventually took me 4 years of running the takeoff program to recognize I'm actually neglecting that part of my niche and the takeoff program. And that's actually where I have the biggest impact. I get the biggest results. I can make the biggest change in people's lives. So definitely a long time for me to learn that lesson and stop getting myself caught up in shiny object syndrome and trying to create program after program after program to continuously mentor those people through that journey. I understand people want to hang on and be like, Tash, I want the next part to come from you. I'm a very unique person in the way that I teach business and the way that I teach marketing and sales and the consent-driven marketing strategies. I totally understand that. But if I had waited until I'd got the takeoff program rocking and rolling and really launching at scale effectively before I'd created that next program and that next program and that next program, then I would have done a much better job of, number one, growing my business, number two, helping as many people as possible, number three, creating that epic profitability and scalability in my business, number four, really ensuring that I was focusing down and not burning myself out by trying to create and manage and launch multiple programs all at once. Number three, big lesson, live delivery first time around. And I have definitely learned this lesson and applied that lesson to a bunch of different things that I've done since then. And I'm so grateful that I learned that lesson. So the first time I created the takeoff program, I was working with a mentor who was more about passive income and creating a self-study program, an information product. And so the intention was not to actually have live support calls in the takeoff program eventually. So in the first round, she recommended having three or four calls just to answer people's questions and make sure they could get through the process and then turn it into a self-study program for $2,000. And actually, it was very early in that process that I recognized people need mentoring through this phase of business. Sure, there are other courses and programs where it might be appropriate not to have live support calls and for people to do that as a self-study journey, but creating an online business and going through those early stages of startup and getting to the point where you're making consistent sales at scale, that requires mentoring. And there's just too many choose your own adventure parts of that pathway for me to be able to confidently and in integrity say to people, you are likely to get the outcomes without live support calls. I think that the mentoring component of the takeoff program is critical. And so that was a big lesson for me in the takeoff program. Deliver the program live first so that you can walk people through that process, because I pre-recorded all of the takeoff modules. And actually, by the time we got to module 5, I recognized I put too much into each module, but I'd already pre-recorded them. So what I needed to do was re-record the takeoff program for the second round. And then I in the second round, I still realized that I hadn't quite got that process right. And so the third time I ran the takeoff program, I actually ran it as a live program. And that's where the current format and structure of the takeoff program came from. And that was a very powerful live round of the program that actually gave me all the insight and information that I needed to really pace it out appropriately and ensure I was covering off on the key decisions that people needed to make along that journey. So if I could rewind and go and decide, I'm not going to pre-build the takeoff program, I'm going to deliver it live the first time around, I definitely would do that. And I'm glad that I eventually did do a live delivery and was able to walk through and get all of those lessons and really secure and nail down what that process was. Lesson number four is boundaries, boundaries, boundaries. And there have been several times throughout the takeoff journey that I have required a little tightening of boundaries and just reaffirming those boundaries. Now, that being said, the more successful the takeoff program becomes, the more I need to encourage people to creep closer to the boundaries, because people join the takeoff program and assume they can't ask me questions. They join the takeoff program and assume they can't ask things that might be slightly out of the box. They join the takeoff program and assume that they're not going to get any time with me, but that's actually not the case. And something that I've done in the takeoff program, both in the last iteration and this current recording of the takeoff program, is that I have a module on boundaries and I talk specifically about those boundaries and I encourage people to be a squeaky wheel because my boundaries are my responsibility. Here's where my boundaries lie. Here's where I can and cannot help you. But if you're not sure, just ask. And I have to encourage people to do so because the more successful the takeoff program becomes, the less people expect to get that support from me, but they do actually get it. So it's something that I have definitely learned a lot of lessons about over the years in running the takeoff program. And I'm continually renegotiating those boundaries with myself and also with my takeoff students. And then lesson number five, and this is something that I assumed I could let go of the minute I started the takeoff program, and that is I still do sales conversations with people. And I now, looking back, recognize that one of the reasons why I was so keen to have a group program and a course was because I thought it was going to get me out of having to do sales conversations and sales calls one-to-one, because it was something that I still wasn't 100% confident and comfortable with at the time of launching the takeoff program. But when I don't have that opportunity for people to message me one-to-one and then jump on a call if we need to, then I know that I'm missing out on useful, powerful information about what people might be assuming about the takeoff program, what their resistance points might be, the unique and individual circumstances in which maybe it is or isn't a good fit. It's a bit of a gray area. And also, I would say at least 50% of the people who join the takeoff program still email me about it first before joining, and I encourage them to do that. And the more I encourage that, the better my conversion rates are, because we can't account for every single individual circumstance on our sales page. I think it's important that people feel really confident and comfortable with their decision to purchase. And that little bit of extra access to me in the sales process reflects the level of access people get to me inside the takeoff program. So therefore, I think it's appropriate. And I wish I could go back and tell myself when I was first starting the takeoff program, don't do this to avoid having conversations with people about purchasing from you. Do this through the lens of using the high connection, high conversion strategies that you already have and that already work so well to maximize conversion into the takeoff program. You're not just leveraging your time in the sales process, you're leveraging your time in the delivery, and so still giving people some one-to-one connection with you, whether that's in written form or on sales calls, is going to supercharge your ability to sell at scale. So don't resist it, Tash. I wish I could tell myself that. I can't go back and tell 2014 Tash that, so I remind 2021 Tash of that quite consistently. And I also share that insight with everyone who asks me about creating and launching online programs. Now, they are my five top lessons from having sold over $1 million worth of spots in the Takeoff program over the last 7 years. But I also wanted to use this podcast as an opportunity to let you know that I am going to be diving back into having a program where I help you create and launch your leveraged products and services in your business. So if you are now looking at creating your own group program or a membership or an online course or something along those lines, then I would love to invite you to jump onto my VIP alert list for my new program, which is called Leverage and Launch. This program will be opening its doors and kicking off in June 2021. But if you're on the VIP alert list, you'll get access to a special opportunity when I open doors to the VIP alert list. And there's an extra juicy discount for people who are on that VIP alert list as well. So if you head on over to tashcorbin.com/271, I'll make sure the link to get on the alert list is there if it's still open. If it's not open, if you're listening to this well after it has been released, then the link that's with the show notes will direct you straight to the sales page to come and join us in Leverage and Launch. But if you go to tashcorbin.com/271, the link will be there at the bottom of the page. Make sure you go and check that one out. The Leverage and Launch program will be my most comprehensive program to help you not only build a leveraged product, but also pre-launch, runway, and launch, as well as review and refine your group program. So it is a super comprehensive program. It is going to be a VIP group program, and spaces will be limited in the first round. I'm only launching it once in 2021, and so spaces will be limited in that first pilot live round. They will be super discounted, and there will be limited spaces. So make sure you jump on that VIP alert list. If spaces sell out with the VIP alert list alone, I will not be doing a public launch of this program in 2021. So make sure you go over to tashcorbin.com/271 and jump on that VIP alert list if you'd like my support to create and launch your own group program or leveraged product. Until next time, I cannot wait to see you shine, and I'll see you on the next episode of the Heart Centered Business Podcast. Bye for now. Would you like more tips, tools, and resources to help you grow your heart-centered business? Head to tashcorbin.com today.